sipping on booze in the house of blues. It's the Hey guys, it's me. So today we're going to be talking about gaining arm size, growing your arms, your guns. Welcome to the gun show. Number one thing is going to be supersetting your biceps and triceps. Biggest mistake I see people doing push, pull, leg day split, they're doing back and bis, chest and tris. They're never supersetting the two arm muscles. What this is going to do, create a unique pump. It's really going to change the way you you train arms. And usually you do this on its own day. So number two is bulk. Eat in a caloric surplus for an extended period of time, at least 6 months. Gain some size that way. I have heard it said that for every 10 pounds in weight that you gain, you have the potential to gain another inch on your arms. So I think there's definitely some truth to that. Number three, make sure you go on a cut. So after you bulked, make sure you cut. The leaner you are, the better you will look. I guarantee you, no matter how much muscle you have, if you get lean enough, you will like the way you look, especially in respect in regards to your arms. You know, I've gotten a lot of compliments lately about my arms, and they haven't gotten bigger, they've just gotten juicier because I've just been on cut for the past 10 weeks. Alright, number four, 1 day for arms. Set aside 1 out of 7 days to devote to arm training, buys and tries, you got it. Alright, number five, frequent arm training. So yes, you've got 1 day for arms, but also frequently sprinkle them in at the end of your workouts. So do like biceps at the end of your back workout. This has really helped me in recent training with my contest prep. I found that I was able to maintain or even grow my arms in size just through training them frequently. Which leads me to number six, volume. So you want to make sure that you're getting enough volume. Volume is defined as reps times sets times weights. So you want to increase reps, sets, and weights, and make sure that you're getting enough volume to trigger muscle growth. There is an optimal level of volume for everybody to achieve hypertrophy. So you don't want to overtrain and you don't want to undertrain. And I find that the arms really respond to high volume training a lot. In the, you know, I'd say the same for shoulders. They respond well to that. And you know, I've done high volume arm training workouts before. I did like 1140 reps with Steve Weatherford's Armageddon workout. I've done that 5 times. I've seen really good results with that. I'm not a huge fan of like the feeder workouts that Rich Piana recommended. Never seen results from that. But, which leads me to my next thing, because feeder workouts are designed to get you a pump but not really tear down any muscle fiber, I think you should do the opposite, which is focus on tearing down the muscle fibers with enough volume, heavy weights you should hurt during your workout from going heavy. Obviously in a good way, not like tendon or like joint stress. Anyway, which leads me to my next eighth point, which is progressive overload, another way to grow muscle. So, you know, tearing down muscle fiber, that's more about metabolic stress. Progressive overload is going to be more about just going heavier. So Dorian Yates was quoted as saying, if you look at a guy curling like 30-pound dumbbells and come back to him a year later and he's still curling the same weights, his arms are going to be the same size. I think there's a lot of truth to that. So you definitely need to go heavier over time. As you get better at the movements, go heavier with the exercise. Number nine is hit every head of the triceps and biceps. What I mean by that, there's three heads to the tricep, tri meaning three, lateral head, long head, and medial head. You want to make sure you hit all three to make a complete arm workout. Also for the biceps, you've got the inner, outer head, and then you've got this third part, which is like the biceps brachialis, which is kind of not visible from the outside, but it will put more girth on your arm. And you hit that through neutral grip contractions. Alright, so like hammer curls. And the 10th thing we're going to talk about is getting a stretch, a pump, and a contraction throughout your arm workout. Make sure that you designate an exercise to stretch, pump, and contract the muscle. For example, for stretching out the biceps. What does that? Incline curls. Those are a good one. Probably a few other ones. A good one for getting a pump is just constant tension, right? So what's good for that? Cables. Doing like cable curls or something like that. And like for contraction, anytime you hear someone talk about like training the biceps for peak contraction, they're talking about like bringing the elbow up, getting a peak contraction, a really tight contraction. That is going to be the best one for that. So some examples for that would be spider curls, concentration curls, like extend, you know, I don't know what these are called, but you're lifting your elbows up, you're doing a cable curl. So yeah, anyway, I hope you guys learned something from this video. More training videos coming. So let me know if you liked it. Like the button, subscribe, and I will see you next time. Bye. I need to know.